also follow and watch Wrestle Vlogs, the best wrestling in Texas.
What is up, guys? Welcome back to another vlog. We're right here in the first time ever, for the first time ever, Wrestle Vlogs is right here in Uvalde, Texas. We're right here getting ready for Super Saturday. As you guys can see, the ring is in the back. The fans are already getting in. So, Super Saturday, once again, there's going to be two shows in one day here in Uvalde. It's pretty exciting, you know. We got the Wrestle Vlogs Championship going on the line tonight with the first show, Ringside Records and Wrestling. It's going to be Juventud Aérea versus Pistolero Banderas, and I've seen Pistolero wrestle a lot of times when I started getting into the indie scene in Texas. One of the first guys I saw that caught my attention, so let's see how that match goes tonight. And as well, AWP Atlas Wrestling Promotion is the home promotion here in Uvalde, and we're going to check out what they got in store. It's going to be the first time it's mentioned here in Uvalde, and checking out Atlas Wrestling Promotion and Ringside Records. Well, I've been wanting to check out both shows, and if you want, today is a good day to check it out. All right, guys, so let's check what's the round, and I'll catch y'all later. We just arrived here in Uvalde, and we're in a brand new segment. We're doing a brand new segment. Aquí estamos en Uvalde. Vamos a hacer un segmento nuevo que he tratado de hacer ya. Hemos tratado de hacer aquí en WrestleVlogs ya por un tiempo. Lo hicimos una vez, pero se fueron los files, los files de los videos. We did this before. We did it with The Kingdom, with Rob Love, Sustash, and The Kingdom, if you know who The Kingdom is, from Texas. So we did this thing called Food Reviews. One time, what was more of a snack review? We were reviewing snacks, and unfortunately, that file got corrupted and we don't have the file anymore. So, we've been planning this for a while. Ya estamos planeando esto por un tiempo. Y ahora lo que se va a hacer, lo que se trata este segmento, es de que vamos a probar snacks. O si no, le voy a dar a los luchadores que prueben snacks o comidas a donde vayamos. So, what this segment is involved is that. These wrestlers are gonna give me snacks. They're gonna give me some snacks to try from wherever, I guess. And then as well, we'll do it back. We'll take out the wrestlers to eat or something, and then we'll make them try some snacks that they never tried out before. So vamos a empezar este segmento con ¿qué me trajiste, güey?
Pues
de tu tierra.
Aprovechando, ¿no? El nuevo segmento, como todos lo saben o la mayor parte lo saben, yo soy de Tampico, Tamaulipas, y de ahí. Se conoce un dulce típico que se llama las duquesas. Es una tortilla de coco hecho, bueno, con merengue artesanal. Todo está hecho artesanal. La verdad, ya tiene años este dulce típico. Mucha gente de aquí, de Estados Unidos, de Monterrey, Matamoros, de diferentes lados, va solamente a Tampico a consumir las duquesas. Pueden encontrarlas en la página de Facebook como Duquesa de Manuel. Y pues a continuación les voy a mostrar, déjame checar, a ver si las pueden ver, aquí tantito.
Mira bien, güey, look good. So, once again, I didn't say it, güey, otra vez.
A tú, por favor.
So, what he mentioned is that they're like little tacos. Son como pequeños tacos. Uh-huh. Y what it's basically made out of is handmade handmade, ¿verdad? Handmade whipped cream. So es este, ¿cómo se dice whipped cream en español?
Es como merengue, todo merengue artesanal.
Merengue artesanal hecho a mano. También este, so it's wrapped with, as mentioned, it's cocoa. So this is like cocoa, this is not a tortilla anything. So esto es cocoa, pero también tiene este relleno de
merengue.
Mm-hmm. So it has a whipped cream filling. So I'm gonna give it a try, le voy a dar una probada. Este, se ve que Juve ya se robó los que me iba a regalar.
Venían 5, pero la verdad como tenía mucho hambre en el camino, me robé 2, así que nada más llegaron 3 aquí vivas.
Ok, so here we go once again, aquí vamos, ¿cómo saben?
Pruébalas, pruébalas.
¿Sabes que no voy a ir al baño después?
No, quiero ver que lo pruebes. Y después me dices qué tal saben. Son mis dulces favoritos cuando voy. Y regreso a Tampico, es lo primero que llego y compro para estar comiendo.
You say so good. I don't know if I'm really sure most of y'all people have tried those candy bars with the Mexican flag. With cocoa. That's what it tastes like, pretty much. But this is way better, and it's more like of a filling, excuse me, of like whipped cream. So, esto es como las barras mexicanas de coco, pero es mucho mejor esta. Es mucho mejor. Y tiene, pues obviamente, es como las barras de coco, pero si estuvieran rellenados con merengue. Merengue, ¿verdad?
Sí, formativo.
Ahora sí soy mexicano. Pero así es, este, la comida esta. ¿Y cómo se prepara esto?
Esto. La verdad, todo nace del coco. Se corta el coco, se raya, se empieza a rallar el coco, hacen una mezcla para hacer la tortilla. Y pues el merengue, pues, es un secreto de Duquesa San Manuel. La verdad, nunca me quisieron decir lo que es, ¿verdad? Porque pues es un secreto de cómo se hace el merengue. Y pues la verdad, están muy ricas. No porque sean de Tampico, lo tengo que decir, pero la verdad, sí están muy, muy, muy ricas. Cualquier chance que vayan a Tampico, contacten a Duquesa San Manuel y pidan las suyas, porque la verdad no se las van a dejar de comer.
Yo digo que esto es más a los que le gustan bastante el dulce, porque sí está bien dulce. Yo tengo una tolerancia en lo dulce. I have a tolerance on sweetness, so I would recommend for anybody that likes anything like super, super sweet. So as you mentioned, these are made out of like the cocos. They cut up the cocos, they scarf it out, or they scratch it out, they scratch all the cocoa out, and they put it in a mixer to make, they do like a mixture. They don't put it in a blender or anything. They do everything by hand. So they put it, they do it in a tortilla. The whipped cream is a secret family recipe that they use and they do. So then he was saying that the place in Tampico where they sell these, they don't want to give them the recipe because it's very, very sacred. Pero este sí, güey, pues estas están muy buenas. Y pues este, pues otra vez hablando del nuevo segmento, así va a ser las cosas. Me van a Juve o alguien más va a traer unos snacks para probar, o si no yo les traigo unos snacks a ellos para que ellos prueben. Y pues este, no nomás vamos a hablar también de la comida, pero también en una entrevista. Pero esto es un breve de cómo va a ser todo el nuevo segmento, y estoy muy emocionado por empezar este nuevo segmento. So I'm really excited to start this new segment that I've been wanting to do for quite a while. And once again, we're going to do like, it's going to be like an interview style. We're going to have a food and talk about the food, where it's from and stuff like that. And that's why I like a little interview per se. But I really want to thank everybody for joining into this video, and continue watching the vlog. All right, so let's continue with the vlog or whatever.
Amigos, si recuerden comprar productos oficiales de Ubisoft, y también encontramos con nueva mercancía de Wrestler Blocks, esa camisita patrocinada por Wrestler Blocks. Recuerdenlo, soy Juventud Aérea, Wrestler Blocks, y yo vamos a hacer historia.
Me de palgas. Okay, guys, that was the end of the vlog, the last vlog of 2021 here on WrestleBlogs. We had a great successful year here for WrestleBlogs. We crowned the first ever WrestleBlogs champion, first champion Ruben Steeles, then the next champion was Príncipe Celestial, and now the current champion Juventud Aérea. And as well, we got another international partnership running with Tampico Lucha Fan from Tampico, Mexico. So now we got them, and as well Talking Crap from the UK and United Kingdom, and a lot of great stuff, a lot of great partnership, a lot of great working with promotions around the state, just working with Ringside Records, as you can see, AWP, Atlas Wrestling Promotion, Wrestle Rave, Local Wrestling, Puro Pinche Wrestling, GCWA, and a lot of other promotions out there that have given us a chance to show out the WrestleBlogs Championship and showcase the great talent from Texas that WrestleBlogs would like to show out and provide for the fans around the state. Alright guys, that'll be the end of the vlog. It was a great time in Novale. Going first time in Novale, it was a fun time, fun night. The WrestleBlogs Championship was defended, and it was Pistolero Valderas versus Juventud Aérea. Y'all saw the highlights. It was a great match, and we hope to see back Pistolero Valderas for another shot of the WrestleBlogs Championship, because I think he deserves another shot for that championship. But 2022 is coming up. A lot of great things are coming up for 2022, man. Like, whew, I could tell y'all what's coming up for 2022, but just keep an eye on the vlog, man. A lot of great things happened in 2021, as mentioned. International partnership, the champion crown, working with more promotions, our audience growing. It's been great, but all of this is because we love Texas wrestling, and we do it for Texas wrestling, for the Texas wrestling talent, the scene, everybody, all the promotions and stuff like that. And we truly appreciate the support. The long drives, it's always stressful, especially recently with our car problems and stuff like that. But I just want to thank you guys for the support. It really means a lot. It takes a lot of hours to edit, to do the rides, to record and stuff like that. So I really appreciate the support. All right, guys, I know there is people that don't like us. There's people that just don't want to see and succeed, and that's fine. We'll keep rolling. We'll keep doing, providing our content. We don't care about any negativity around here. We'll just keep rolling with our content and stuff like that. All right, guys, we still have some merch. Get your WrestleBlogs hats, shirts, and a store will be opening soon. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching, and see you next year.
Te lo seco a la verga, ey. Tú eres la mera verga, güey. Y yo agarro todas las vergas y me los como.